In 1908, thousands of women rallied in New York City for better working conditions and their rights to vote. That gathering led to a bigger event, the women's suffrage. Women were often overlooked until brave women like Harriet Tubman, Susan B. Anthony, and Elizabeth Cady Stanton led the Suffrage Act, gaining women our rights to vote. In 1980, the National Women's History Project lobbied for national recognition. They were heard, and President Jimmy Carter issued and signed the first proclamation for Women's History Week. 6 years later, they petitioned for an expansion of this event, and Congress passed Bill 100-9 in March of 1987, proclaiming March as Women's History Month. Women like Elizabeth Blackwell in 1849 was able to become the first female doctor after being ostracized and harassed by the townspeople and the male student body. At first, even being barred from classroom demonstrations. In 1997, Madeleine Albright was the first woman to serve as Secretary of State, and she continues to be active today. Mary Dixon Keyes, the first woman to own a patent. She was weaving hats, and President James Madison's wife saw this, recognized it, and President Madison then signed her patent. Mary Curry, the first woman to win a Nobel Prize. Harriet Tubman, who against all odds raised above everything for her role with leading people to freedom. We all remember Amelia Earhart, the first woman to fly the Atlantic Ocean solo in 1932. There's the Helen Kellers, the Margaret Thatcher, Queen Elizabeth, Oprah Winfrey, and so many more amazing women leading us today. Women of the world want and deserve an equal future, free from stigma, a future that is sustainable, peaceful, with equal rights and opportunities for all of us. To get us there, the world needs a woman at every table where discussions are being made. Because when women lead, we see positive results. March 8th is to celebrate the role of women in history and to remind ourselves of the accomplishments of women throughout the years and to reflect on the trailblazing women who led our way for change. I'd like to acknowledge three amazing trailblazers in our community that have impacted my life: Betsy Yates, Lois Gordy, and Judy Culpepper. They've opened many doors for me, they've helped me educate myself, and they've mentored me to become who I am today, and I'm forever thankful to the three of them. The women's rights movement has afforded women many opportunities and privileges through the years. I proudly served as president of the League of Women Voters in St. Lucie County for 8 years. And I'm proud to work for 320,000 wonderful bosses each day in my elected position today, all because of these past historical women. I've learned that nothing in life is to be feared. It is to be understood. And now is the time to understand more so we all fear less.
My mother comes from the Dominican Republic. I was born and raised in Miami, Florida. We're in North America. There's so many inspiring women in my life that have inspired me. Women are, in my life, very spiritually motivated. They have been the backbone and the strength that I idolize. Women have, in the past, in history, as well as present and in my future, God willing, they will be very strong, independent, and spiritual women. I have had a lot of things in my life that have been guided and inspired by these women. And I hope that this month they know how important they are to all of us.
I have countless memories of being motivated and empowered by women whom I've known personally and those whom I've read about in books. To me, women empowerment consists of encouraging, providing constructive feedback, and showing even the smallest acts of kindness to the women I encounter. It is a beauty of embracing the creativity that comes with positively interacting with women of diverse race, culture, and socioeconomic status. To all the women in leadership, the mothers, the sisters, the aunts, the daughters, and the mentors who empower others, thank you. I can empower because I've been empowered.
There are so many inspirational women out there, but the most that matter to me would have to be my mom and my grandmother. When I think of my mother, you know, she raised me as a single parent, always making sure that I was, you know, going to all my after-school activities and never taking time for herself, and just very selflessness. So I wouldn't be the person that I am today without my mom. My grandmother moved here in 1960, picked up her whole family, my grandfather who had just been in a car accident and was left brain damaged, moved down to Florida with nothing in her pockets and became a successful businesswoman, making a name for herself. You know, it's very, very humbling. When thinking about Women's History Month, these are the two people that come to my mind. You know, strong, empowering people who made sacrifices to make my life better, and I wouldn't be the person I am today.
Women History Month means everything. It is the month we celebrate women in history who have paved the way for us. It is about perseverance, encouragement, and empowerment. It is the month that we went from not being able to vote to having our first female vice president in office. It is about having our daughters and even their daughters being able to have more opportunity to be whatever they choose to be.
Women's History Month makes me think back over a 30 plus year career of the women that influenced me and how hard all of us had to work to be leaders in our fields. I can say that I had to work, I feel, twice as hard as the male to be in a leadership role. And but that's my generation. And it was worth every second of it. And in doing that, I think along those lines, in that you have to work harder, you also become more aware of the people around you and their feelings and how they react to you as their leader. Because as a female in a leadership role, you don't always get the respect that you deserve. And so therefore you try to counterbalance that. And how I did that was with empathy. And I've taken that role probably to an extreme distance, and I use empathy to resolve problems with employees and even citizens in the community. And so that is kind of, to me, what it means, my message as a female and the influences that I experienced in my career.
So it's Women's History Month. And Women's History Month makes me think about women in planning because that's what I do. And one of the things that I have learned is that we tend to create spaces for everyone, for what we think is everyone. But when we do that, we tend to create spaces that work primarily for men. Here's an example. When you have a transit facility and you have to go up some stairs in order to get to it, you aren't planning for women with strollers. You're not planning for people who have disabilities. You're planning for men who can easily run up the stairs and get on the train. Women in our society bear a disproportionate amount of the care of the very young and the very old. And so when you think about what the needs of women are in our built environment, well-lit sidewalks, good transitions because of strollers, you're really planning for children, you're really planning for the elderly, you're really planning for the disabled. So we need to start seeing women in planning. And that's what Women's History Month makes me think about.
So to all you amazing and beautiful women out there, be bold, be brave, and be fearless.